Good evening. My name is Cleo. They are the words that have brought an entire nation pure joy and made seasoned detectives cry. Tonight, Cleo Smith is back with her mum and dad after being missing for 18 excruciating days. The four-year-old was found by WA police officers in the early hours of this morning when they busted into a locked home in the remote town of Carnarvon. The little girl vanished from her family tent during a camping trip back on October the 16th, to then be found alive and well just 7 metres drive from her family home is simply incredible. A Carnarvon man is now in custody after what's proved to be life-saving detective work.
Sitting up and smiling, little Cleo doesn't realise just how many people she's waving to. The whole of Australia has been waiting to see her face. For 18 agonising days, the Smiths were separated until a midnight mission brought their little girl home.
We said we wouldn't give up. We said we would keep on searching, and we dared to hope.
She was found alone in a locked house in regional WA.
I said, "What's your name?" And she didn't answer, and I said, "What's your name?" She didn't answer again. So I asked her a third time, and then she looked at me and she said, "My name's Cleo."
Cleo's mother, Ellie, sharing the good news to social media, writing, "Our family is whole again. The discovery after so long rocking the quiet town of Carnarvon and the country."
It's a shock for the community and for everybody in this town.
She touched everybody's heart, you know, and I'm happy that she got found.
And never in my 68 years have I seen anything like this or heard anything like this.
Every parent's worst nightmare, and the fact that that nightmare has come to an end and our worst fears were not realised is just a huge relief.
It often is a tragic outcome, but this is great news and uplifting for the entire country, and especially for those people who put their heart and soul into finding little Cleo.
People were in tears. It's fair to say it was just an amazing outcome. We hoped, we kept working with that belief that we could get there, we could find Cleo. And look, I don't know what happened, but we were lucky and we did.
100 officers and volunteers have spent close to 3 weeks scouring the sea, sand, sky and scrub. The family arrived for a holiday on Friday the 15th at the Blowholes campground, 70 kilometres from Carnarvon. Cleo was last seen in her tent at 1:30 a.m. the next morning. When her mum Ellie woke up just before 6:30, she was gone and so was her sleeping bag. Police moving quickly, setting up a roadblock, sending out the SES and flying homicide detectives up from Perth. A car was seen around the area, but the driver was never able to be located. But Cleo was. After 18 days of searching, this morning, just before 1 a.m, police broke down the door of a house in Carnarvon. There, they found Cleo. The house Cleo was found in is just minutes away from her family home. It's understood it was a tip-off from a Carnarvon local that led officers here, where she was found inside and alone. Her mum Ellie and stepdad Jake were never suspects, but that didn't stop the court of public opinion from condemning them.
They've been through a lot over the last 18 days. Terrible trauma, some vicious attacks and some... no doubt very, very trying and sad time.
We want our daughter back and she wants us. Our daughter, Isla, she needs her big sister. We need her home.
Less than 5,000 people live in Carnarvon. Everybody knows everybody, which means you have a whole town working the case, and $1 million reward was on the line.
The police was coming and going and questioning, going to people's house and knocking on doors.
A 36-year-old man is in custody. He has no connection to the family.
Yes, we have one man in custody, but that is not the town of Carnarvon. You know, that is one person. And I want the town of Carnarvon and everyone else to come together as a community as we move forward.
There's a long road ahead. There will be a court case and no doubt counselling and more questions.
But for now, welcome home, Cleo.
Well, let's go to Carnarvon now and Steph Baumgartel. Steph, what more do we know about this man in custody?
Sandra, the 36-year-old man only became a suspect yesterday. Police swooping on his home as soon as they could, bringing little Cleo Smith back into the arms of her parents early this morning. This discovery has been described as the result of hard police grind, but even they say they were shocked when they found her inside the home. We understand she's spent the day in hospital, where she's described as safe and well. Meanwhile, the investigation here in Carnarvon will ramp up as detectives work to build a case against the 36-year-old accused. Sandra, he's been flown to Perth, where charges are expected to be laid later today.
All right, Steph, thanks for the update.